to online summer camp at Hebei University of Chinese Medicine. I'm Maggie. In the previous lesson, we have learned how to greet with each other and make self-introduction in Chinese. Let's review it briefly. 您好，我叫安娜，我是巴西人，我是一名律师。我喜欢吃牛排，我的爱好是学汉语。 Today, we are going to have a look at the Chinese people's daily life. First of all, let's get a general idea of the changes in Chinese people's clothing, food, housing, and transportation over the past 70 years through a short video. From the video, we can see that things have changed a lot in many aspects of people's daily life. There are many foreigners in China for work or study, with the number in Beijing, Shanghai, and Guangzhou the top three. Next, we are going to watch a video about some foreigners' view of what it's like to live in China.The foreigners were interviewed randomly in the street. Let's see how they feel about living in China.
I really like all the good restaurants here, especially a lot of good international combined with Chinese restaurants. I like a lot.
Transportation. Shanghai's public transportation is absolutely remarkable. You have many options and it's also very affordable.
Food is great. Transport is unbelievably good. Buying clothes is fantastic. And I haven't bought a house, so I'm not sure.
I would agree with what you
said. Clothes? Yeah. I mean, you have Taobao and everything.
I think food.
Oh, yeah,
because
food.
Chinese food is like local food, it's reasonable, but I think Western food is kind of like, you know, too expensive. Sometimes it's like pricey,
So I think transportation system in Shanghai is quite satisfying because there are so many people living here and everybody's using bikes and motorbikes, and not so many people are using cars, so there's quite less traffic for such a big city. It's,quite nice.
I think all of those are very satisfied. China is just very convenient for shopping and living. Everything's very convenient.
Food, above all, because you have very cheap restaurants and it's excellent food. It's by far the best food we can have in the world. Chinese food is incredible. Even Western food is cheap. Like if I had to have like one reason for coming to China, it would be food.
sometimes the Chinese tend to be spitting on the floor. It's not common in my country. Sometimes the air is a little bit polluted, but it's okay. Today it's nice. Pollution, I think you should get rid of some of the cars inside the town.
Sometimes buying food. I find over the last 7 years the cost of living has increased significantly and the cost of food has increased. And sometimes I'm concerned as well about food safety. I think unsatisfied is quite a heavy word because I know that things will continue to get better and better.
Nothing.
I like food, but sometimes I get diarrhea from street food and maybe I eat some too random, I think.
No, okay,
I mean, I like food, which is unsatisfied, but it's also, I can also get diarrhea from it. You get what I mean? Like, I mean, I like food, but it's not... It can go on such a time, is it? Yeah, food for me. Yeah, keep it clean.
What I realized when you go for shopping and you try to shop clothes and stuff, you just want to buy, I don't know, a t-shirt or jacket or something that's more expensive than in Europe. I didn't expect that next week.
I can't think of any. I'm very satisfied with all of those options.
Yeah, I would say landlords in China or like the agencies that take care of your apartments. There's a lot of scams going around apartments. Many foreigners get scammed around, and I would say I'm most unsatisfied about transportation. And also finding your apartment is not always very easy in China because you have to find some good deals amongst the bad ones. So housing and transportation are most difficult, I think, if you don't speak Chinese.
Now we know that most foreigners speak highly of life in China, in spite of a little dissatisfaction, which is common in every nation. Okay, now let's start from the closing in ancient China. 衣服 means clothing. The costume in the picture is called 汉服. It refers to the traditional clothing of the Han people who lived in China before the Qing dynasty. Nowadays, more and more young people in China have begun to wear hanfu again to show their love for traditional Chinese culture. We are going to watch a video clip of hanfu show held in Shanghai. As most parts of China have four distinct seasons, that is spring, 春天, summer, 夏天, autumn, 秋天 and winter, 冬天。People dress differently in different seasons. Besides, we also pay great attention to dressing on different occasions. For example, on business occasions, men usually wear suits with a tie, while women wear suit dress. Read after me. 西装，西装。Which means suit. 领带，领带。Which means tie. And 套裙，套裙。Which means suit dress. On ordinary social occasions, such as at a party, watching a show, or gatherings for friends and family members,Chinese people choose to wear fashionable clothes with distinctive personality. For example, they wear 礼服 and 旗袍 and also 高跟鞋. Here is a question. Do you think Chinese ladies always wear 旗袍? Of course not. Let's watch a video to check it out.
Do as the Chinese do. This is the third episode of the stereotypes course about Chinese 旗袍. Have you ever paid attention to the dresses when you see Chinese women's characters on the screen? If you observe carefully, you will find that all the roles of Chinese women, no matter in movies, TV dramas, or even cartoons, they are all in 旗袍. So do you think that all the Chinese women always wear 旗袍? Actually, it's a stereotype. Firstly,In the long history of China, each dynasty has its own representative traditional costumes. 旗袍 was mainly popular in the Qing Dynasty and Republic of China. It has originated from the Manchu ethnic group. Secondly, as a kind of ceremonial dress, 旗袍quite often appears on fashion shows, weddings, or social parties. Do Chinese women always wear 旗袍? Of course not.
On casual occasions,We choose clothes of natural and comfortable style. For example, we wear jeans, 牛仔服, sportswear, 运动服, t-shirt, 剃须, shirt, 衬衣, jacket, 夹克衫. When we go shopping, ramble about the street, or travel.Besides, we also have wind coat, 风衣, shorts, 短裤, sweater, 毛衣, downwear, 羽绒服, for spring, summer, autumn, and winter. For accessories, we have socks, 袜子, gloves, 手套, and scarf.围巾 China has many famous clothing brands such as 波司登鄂尔多斯李宁珊珊罗蒙美特斯邦威红豆 Do you know any of these brands? You must have heard of 波司登 becauseNow it has already become well known for its downwear sold all over the world. Okay, tell me how people in your country dress themselves. Are there any similarities? Next comes food. 食 Have you ever heard any Chinese food? How does it taste?This is a map of Chinese food. China is very famous for its rich and varied cuisine. The most well-known food are the eight cuisines, that is Shandong cuisine, Sichuan cuisine, Anhui cuisine, Fujian cuisine, Jiangsu cuisine, Hunan cuisine, 浙江 cuisine, and 广东 cuisine. Let's look at them one by one. First one, Shandong food. It's famous for its fresh and tender characteristics. Next one is Sichuan cuisine. It's spicy and fragrant. Cantonese cuisine is rich in color, slippery but not greasy. Jiangsu cuisine are crisp and sweet. Fujian cuisine is famous for its seafood, sour, sweet, and salty. Zhejiang cuisine is crisp and tender. Hunan cuisine, they are rich in seasoning, sour and sweet. Anhui cuisine is simple in seasoning and mellow in taste. Now, I'm going to show you the traditional Chinese food we eat at different festivals. First one is Chunjie, that is Chinese New Year or Spring Festival. All the family members will gather together to have family reunion dinner with various kinds of dishes and dumplings. 团圆饭饺子团圆饭饺子 Then comes Lantern Festival, 元宵节 on which people have 元宵 or 汤圆 to celebrate this festival. On Dragon Boat Festival,We have 粽子, that is rice dumplings. On Mid-Autumn Day, we have mooncakes, 月饼, 月饼. On 腊八 Festival, we have 腊八粥, 腊八粥. It's a kind of porridge. What's more,There are also many other special snacks, such as crossing the bridge noodles, 过桥米线, egg puff, 鸡蛋仔, and sweetheart pastry, 老婆饼. Let's see how they are made in the videos.
米线顾名思义是由大米磨成粉做成的粉丝。过桥米线是云南的特色小吃。关于米线的由来，流传着这样一段民间故事：有一位书生为了进京赶考，在湖心亭发奋读书。每天中午，他的妻子都从家里带上热饭送给丈夫吃。但由于路途遥远，饭菜到了湖心亭就凉了。有一天，妻子煲了一锅鸡汤给丈夫送去，打开盖子，鸡汤居然还是滚烫的。原来，汤表面的那层鸡油起到了很好的保温效果。妻子因此产生了灵感，下次送饭的时候，就将一些米线、蔬菜、肉片放到汤里。丈夫吃到滚烫的米线，喝着热热的鸡汤，特别满足。至于过桥米线为什么叫过桥，有人说是因为妻子每次去送饭都要经过一座小桥，饱含着夫妻感情的过桥米线，你一定要。
老婆饼，老婆饼是广州的一种圆形点心，金黄酥松，清甜可口，属于广州潮式月饼的一种。相传清朝末年的一所茶楼里售卖各种点心，一日茶楼里一位点心师傅带了各式各样的招牌点心回家，想给老婆品尝，但是老婆吃了以后嫌弃地说，茶楼的点心竟是如此平淡无奇，没一样比得上我娘家的点心冬瓜饺。点心师傅自然不服，让老婆做出来给她尝尝。于是老婆用冬瓜蓉糖面粉做出了 了焦黄别致的冬瓜饺，师傅吃了以后赞不绝口，也带了一些给茶楼的老板吃。老板吃了以后连忙问：“这位师傅，这是哪家茶楼的点心？”师傅憨憨一笑说：“这是自家老婆做的。”老板就请这位师傅改良了一下冬瓜饺，并取名为“老婆饼”，在茶楼售卖。那么问题来了，吃了老婆饼就能找到老婆吗？
鸡蛋仔，一款风靡香港的街头小吃。鸡蛋仔是一种外壳酥脆、内心软绵的甜点，起源于1950年代的香港。它来源于一个传说：一日，一家杂货店的老板正为了因破口而卖不出去的鸡蛋发愁，无奈之下把面粉和牛油等食材加入蛋浆里，然后倒入模具烘烤。不一会儿，老板闻到甜甜的香味，迫不及待地打开模具，展现在眼前的是金黄的颜色、萌萌的造型。掰下一块放入口中，口感轻盈微甜，奶味浓郁。后来有人为这种糕点设计出鸡蛋状的模具，于是被命名为鸡蛋仔。如今的新吃法是将其卷起并放入一颗冰淇淋球，两种美食结合，给人冰火两重天的双重享受。小贴士，鸡蛋仔一般都是现吃现做，要想吃。
Suppose you come to China for traveling and you want to buy some giftsFor your family or friends. So how do we go shopping in China and what is the best choice? Let's have a look. It's very convenient to buy stuff in China. You can go shopping in a physical store or online. Depends on if you have time or what kind of things you want to buy and you want to buy things for whom. So here we have 实体店 physical store, and also shopping mall, 商场 online store, 网店 Please read after me. 实体店实体店商场商场网店网店 So if you buy something from online stores, you can ask the express delivery, that is 快递快递快递小哥means people who deliver things you buy from online stores. And 包裹 package, 外卖 take out food. If you want to buy something from online stores, you can choose 京东唯品会、当当网、天猫 and 淘宝网。 They have almost everything you need, such as books, clothes, food, daily necessities. And if you don't want to go outside for food, just order 外卖 at 美团外卖、饿了么。And then delicious food will be delivered to your home by 快递小哥 within at most 1 hour. Next, let's see how to ask for price, order meal and pay fees. 多少钱 means how much. 这件衣服多少钱? How much is the clothes?How much is the coat? 那部手机多少钱? How much is the phone? 老板点菜 means I'd like to make an order. I'd like to make an order of food. 老板买单 means I'd like to pay for the food. 一共多少钱?How much is everything? 一共100块。100 RMB。微信还是支付宝 means Do you want to pay by WeChat or Alipay? So read after me. 这件衣服多少钱？那部手机多少钱？老板点菜。老板买单。一共多少钱？一共100块。微信还是支付宝？ For gifts, you can buy a piece of 旗袍 or 丝巾 for a lady. 丝巾 means silk scarf. And you can buy tea or paintings for men.You can buy Beijing Opera facial masks for young people, and you can buy some toys for kids. These are the choices of Chinese culture gifts. Next part, we will look at housing, that is 住Actually, there are 5 traditional Chinese dwellings commonly seen in rural China. First one is 四合院. It's a type of traditional courtyard architecture located in 胡同. As you can see in the picture, it's very spacious.And people of 4 generations live under the same roof. Nowadays, 四合院 are still seen in Beijing. With rich cultural connotations, it has become a historical name card of Beijing. The second type is 天井式住宅. That is 天井 residence.Which are commonly seen in southern regions of Jiangsu province. We also have 客家围龙屋, that is Hakka's round dragon house in Guangdong province, and Hanin buildings in southwest China, such as Guizhou province.Hanging buildings are called 吊脚楼 in Chinese, and also 窑洞 in Shanxi and Henan provinces. 窑洞 is a kind of cave dwelling.
疆域辽阔，自然环境多种多样，社会经济环境不尽相同。在漫长的历史发展过程中，逐步形成了各地不同的民居建筑形式。这种传统的民居建筑深深地打上了地理环境的烙印，生动地反映了人与自然的关系。中国木构架体系的房屋萌芽于新石器时代后期，公元前5000年的浙江省余姚县河姆渡文化遗址反映出当时木构技术水平。洞房也是传统民居，公元前5000年的中国中西部的陕西省西安半坡遗址和临潼江寨的仰韶文化遗址显示了当时村落布局和建筑情况。说明依南北向轴线用房屋围成院落的中国建筑布局方式已经萌芽。
In cities, most Chinese people live in stored houses, which can save space. We call them 楼房。楼房。Some people can afford villas.Which are usually built in suburbs, and they stay in villas at weekends for relaxation. That is 别墅别墅 Finally, we are going to talk about Chinese people's daily transportation. That is 行行 First of all,Let's look at public transportation, 公共交通. For 公共交通 we have buses, 公交车地铁出租车 taxi, 高铁 that is high speed rail. We also have airplane, 飞机 shared bikes, 共享单车大巴车网约车 and 共享汽车 The most popular one is 高铁 and its highest speed is 350 kilometers per hour. Many people choose high-speed rail when they go to other cities. As China's railway system is very developed, so 共享单车 is a very convenient and environmentally friendly transportation means. So how to use 共享单车? Actually, there is a QR code on them. You only need to download the exact app and scan the code. After you use them, you need to park them at the designated area and pay on your phone before you leave. It's very convenient and especially popular among young people. So let's learn how to use them through a short video. COVID-19 pandemic still going on, people are advised to drive their own cars, to go outside so as to avoid potential risks of infection. Walk is also a good way to stay healthy. China is full of scenic spots. It is a very popular destination for travelers.From both at home and abroad. Let's enjoy the beautiful scenery from a video made by a Chinese guy upon his graduation from university. Here, I'd like to thank him a lot for his amazing work. So, how do we ask people if they have ever been to a place in Chinese? Actually, we have talked about it in the previous lesson. We use 你去过北京吗? to ask, have you ever been to Beijing? 我去过北京 means I have been to Beijing before. 我没去过北京 is the opposite meaning. 去过吗? can be used to ask whether you have visited a place, a city or a nation. For example, 你去过天坛吗?你去过天坛吗?你去过鸟巢吗? Please listen carefully to my question and give me your answer. 你去过上海吗?你去过上海吗?你来过石家庄吗? Here I used 来过 because I am here in 石家庄. Well, I'm asking you a question. In 石家庄, we have the most aged stone arch bridge with the largest span all over the world. Next, I'd like to show you a detailed introduction of Beijing, the capital city of China, and also Shanghai, an international metropolis, well known all over the world. We welcome you to visit these cities in the future, especially to my city, Shijiazhuang.
Band or Wai Tan is a must go in Shanghai. Here, the Huangpu River, Huangpu Jiang, divides the city into two parts, the east and the west. To the east of Huangpu River, there are a great number of modern skyscrapers, like Oriental Pearl Redome Television Tower, Dongfang Minzhu, Shanghai Tower, Shanghai Zhongxin Dasha, Shanghai World Financial Center, Huangqiu Jinrong Zhongxin,Jimao Tower, Jimao Dasha, etc. The Oriental Pearl Tower is a television tower, often seen as the synonym of Shanghai. The Shanghai Tower is the highest building in China, which is also the world's second tallest building by height to architectural top, whose design is unique, special, and elegant as well.
As a great nation, China is very strong in manufacturing industry.In terms of clothing, food, housing, and transportation, you must be quite familiar with Made in China, that is, 中国制造. However, there might be some stereotyped impressions of Made in China. Let's watch a video to have a better understanding of 中国制造.
Does Made in China equal to poor quality?Part 1. Clothing. Uniqlo, Zara, UGG, Eland, and the other clothing brands, no matter popular or not, quite a bunch of them are manufactured in China. Part 2. Food. Confucius said, there is no limit when it comes to food and its refinement. You just need to taste Chinese cuisine and enjoy the dance of taste buds. Part 3. Living. Chinese and outer furniture can last centuries and remain timeless, both in physical form and design, and ceramic arts are more of a millennial inheritance.Part 4. Traveling. China's high-speed trains solve all kinds of transportation problems around the world. For example, the Istanbul-Ankara high-speed railway, the Hungary-Serbia railway, and so on. Does Made in China equal to poor quality? Of course not.
Now, let's summarize what we have learned today. That is Chinese people's clothing, food, housing, and transportation. 衣食住行. I hope today's lesson will help you understand China better. Please make a comparison in terms of these four aspects between your country and China, and share it with us. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you very much. Goodbye.